I know what some of you are thinking right now. Haven't we, like, approved this thing, like, 3 or 4 times already? You're technically correct. We've all agreed in principle over the years that this thing was going to 12. But what is this news of yesterday and that we have to approve it again? Well, the short answer is the Pac-12 imploded. So what we were going to have going forward this season with this 12-team playoff model was a 6-6 format. 6, you know, highest rated conference champions with 6 at-larges. With the Pac-12 going bye-bye, they didn't want to keep the 6-6, as that meant we don't want to have 2 group of 5 conference champions in this mix every year guaranteed pretty much. So what that means is they want to make sure that it's only 1 group of 5, because you're going to have the SEC champ, the Big Ten champ, the ACC champ, the new Big 12, which we'll see how well that ages, and you're going to have the American or the Mountain West or the Sun Belt or whomever it may be coming from the quote-unquote group of 5. So that's kind of where all this is kind of coming from with why are we approving this again? Because if you think that's bad, talking about what I talked about a few days ago with the TV deal, apparently that's not official yet either. So we have the college football playoff approved right now, set in stone for at least 2 years. The current format and the television deal. We'll go deeper into that later tonight. I plan to have Eric Lopez back on. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about OU softball and just softball around the country and talk about, you know, probably bring up Florida State and what their next step is, because there's a lot of moving pieces on this chessboard, and I have a few conspiracy theories that I want to bring up to Eric. But getting back to the playoff thing, we had a good 10 years of the 4-team format, and for the most part, it worked. First year was a little rough with the whole TCU-Baylor getting left out thing. There's been a few years where Alabama got in when people thought Ohio State should have gotten in. Just for the most part, the national champion was the national champion. I don't think anyone really has a problem or questions who's the national champ any given year. We finally got into some sort of format where you're not going to have these multiple years where teams are claiming fake championships. Well, I mean, UCF did. They're just right down the street. So we did have 1 year where that happened. But there was no really official selector. They just kind of made it up and put it on their skybox there, on their press box. And it's just like, we're still doing it. It's college football. Wouldn't be the same if nobody in college football did that. But it's going to be impossible to do that in a 12-team format. I know I said impossible in college football, but just bear with me for a moment. So I love the 12-team format because you have 4 teams that you have something to play for. The first round bye. If you're one of the top 4 teams, it gives you time to rest and get things oriented, so you wait and find out where you go play in the Orange Bowl or the Fiesta Bowl. So, but to break down how this is going to work, the first 4 teams are going to get a bye. They're top 4 teams, and they're all going to be conference champions, by the way. So there's not going to be any at-larges, so the second-place SEC team's not going to be number 2. It's going to be like SEC Big 10, ACC Big 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, more than likely the way this is going to be set up. The 5th conference champion that's going to get an automatic bid, whether it's someone from the American or someone from the Sun Belt, Mount West, whatever it may be, they will more than likely be down at 12 and have to play the number 5 team. So the first set of games, like 5 through 12 versus 12, 6 versus 11, 10 versus 8, 8 versus 9, they will be playing on campus. And the first round of games will take place December 20th and 21st. The quarterfinals, which will start some of the bigger bowl games, will be New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. The semis will take place what used to be the kind of the day of the national championship, will be January 9th and 10th, respectively. And the national title game will be January 20th of next year. So just pushing things back a little bit more for the national title game. I think it's going to work. It'll be, I know people are talking about, well, who's going to be able to, our college kids going to be home for Christmas? Are they going to be? I don't think it matters where you play these games. People are going to show up. There is the option, from what I remember, that if your home campus isn't up to snuff or you don't want to host it there, if you are the home team, you can go to the nearest domed stadium nearby to play it there if need be. Because if you're a northern team and there's lots of snow and you want to avoid all that stuff, then, like, if you're Michigan and for whatever reason you don't want to play in the big house, I'm not saying this is happening, but you can move into Detroit and play indoors. I'm just giving that as an example. Or Michigan State. That's probably a better example. So if you don't want to play in the outdoors for whatever reason and have your home stadium, whatever, you can move it to Ford Field potentially or whatever. But yeah, that's kind of where we're at right now with this. So it's been approved multiple times. It's finally done. There was a kerfluffle with like the remaining two Pac-12 teams, Washington State and Oregon State, because they're still kind of trying to be a conference, but they have a scheduling partnership with the Mountain West, and that we're all trying to figure out that stuff and whatnot. It's just been weird. It's just been awfully weird over the past few weeks of saying, they're still doing this? Like, it almost feels like an episode of The Office, where it's like, there's two people there, it's like, they're running the paper company, but instead it's the remaining Pac-12 teams. Probably make a very entertaining comedy TV show, if you ask me. But other than that, that's kind of what went on yesterday, because I was busy ranting and raving against the media bias of Texas and whatnot, and rightfully so. Lots of fun on the social media from some of you people. Anyway, like, subscribe, comment, all those good things YouTubers say. Especially hit the notification bell, because tonight I got a stream tonight with Eric Lopez. A little iffy on the time as I'm recording this. We'll get that figured out, because he's got a few things he's got to do. And tomorrow night, going to say this now, I will have a CDJ from the Gaming Tailgate podcast, and we're going to talk everything, anything, everything about the new EA Sports College Football video game, EA Sports College Football 25. I'm going to get used to the new, I want to say NCAA really badly, but the NCAA title is gone. It's just College Football 25. So we'll talk about everything about that tomorrow night, roughly 9 o'clock Eastern. So I'm still working out the details there. But looking forward to that. So back-to-back nights with streams. And obviously we got some OU sports this weekend with softball and basketball to keep a track of. So until then, if you want to hear me rant and rave or hear my opinions or hear me recap stuff, again, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Also, one quick thing while it's on my mind. If for some reason you're not seeing, because I hear people sometimes say, I don't see your videos. When you go to your YouTube feed, make sure you go to your subscriptions feed if you're subscribed. Because what happens is, if you're on your phone, you go to YouTube, it'll take it to your home page where it has various recommended videos. So if you have a subscription feed, you want to make sure you're hit on the subscription feed, not the home feed. So make sure it's either on the side or the top or whatever. I'm not even sure myself, because I never watch YouTube on my phone very often. But also, if you want to make sure you don't miss a video, like right below, there's the notification bell next to subscribe. So hit the notification bell and you will get a message in your YouTube messages or email letting you know when I drop a video. So with that being said, boomer sooner, catch y'all later. Oh, and also, it is the worst month of the year for guys like me. So if you would like to support the channel, we got super thanks available. Also, I got various Venmo, PayPal, and Cash App in the bottom in the summary there. Every little bit helps, I promise you. February is the worst month. Let's finish February strong. Got a lot of good content coming up. In March, spring football will be here before you know it, and we will be dissecting how great this defensive line is going to be for the next 6 months, because, God, I can't wait for the SEC season one. It's going to be so much fun. Anyway, boomer sooner. You all have a good one.